In the previous videos, we have seen special cases where maximum likelihood or conditional maximum likelihood could be used to estimate the values of the parameters. In this video, we introduce an estimator that can be used in all other cases. And we will also summarize all the findings related to estimation of choice models with various sampling strategies. We introduced an estimator called the weighted exogenous maximum likelihood estimator. It has been suggested by Mansky and Lehrman, and I refer you to the paper for technical details. This is actually basically the same as the ESML, the exogenous sample maximum likelihood, where each term in the sum is weighted. So there is a weight, and so this is why it's called WESML. What is the weight? The intuition behind the weight is that the role or the importance of a given individual in the sample should be inversely proportional to the probability for this person to be selected in the sample. If people with some configuration have a high probability to be selected, well, they will be likely to be overrepresented in the sample, and we will have to put a low weight. But if some people have a low probability to be selected, they are likely to be underrepresented in the sample, and we need to associate them with a high weight. The definition of the weight is simply the inverse of the probability to be selected in the sample, which is this quantity here. To some extent, this is very similar to the weighted least squares in linear regression. This estimator is shown to be consistent, meaning asymptotically unbiased, but is not efficient. It should be used only if nothing else is applicable. So if any of the cases that I presented before, exogenous sampling, or endogenous sample with logit, or endogenous sample with MEV, in this case, you should use the procedures that I've described before. But if not, if none of these cases apply, you should use WESML. Let's try to summarize what we have covered in this analysis of sampling strategies. I have first described to you several sampling strategies that are based on strata. We call them stratified sampling strategies. And we have qualified them: simple random strategy, exogenous, and endogenous. And then we have investigated the impact on estimation of the parameters of each of these sampling strategies. And these are the conclusions that we have reached. If your sample is simple, which I told you never occurs in practice, or is exogenous, in this case, you can use this estimator that we have been using from the beginning, that I call here ESML, exogenous sample maximum likelihood. This is simply this formulation. We solve the maximization problem, where for each individual, we calculate the log of the choice probability. This is a classical procedure, and this is available in most software packages designed to estimate choice models. Then we have seen that if your sample is not exogenous, but you are using a logit model, you can still use ESML, and it will give you a correct estimate of all the parameters of your model, except the constant. And we have seen a way to correct the constants afterwards. The next special case that you have seen is the case when your sample is not exogenous and you are using MEV model. It's similar to what we have done with logit, except that the procedure is a little bit more complicated because you need to include the correction before the estimation. And in all other cases, you should use what I denoted as the weighted exogenous sample maximum likelihood, WESML. And before concluding this topic, I would like to emphasize that all these discussions are related to the estimation of the parameters of the model. Whenever you use a model for forecasting, you always need to correct the sample and to use the weights before you do the aggregation. And this is, I refer you to the lectures on forecasting and aggregation, to analyze this in more details, but all these discussions, I insist, are designed for estimation, not for forecasting.